Carl, this picture, do we know exactly what happened that led to this young woman's death?
Her name, Genesis Carmona. That picture was taken on Tuesday, and she was shot. She took a bullet to the head at the height of anti-government protests in the city of Valencia, about 3 hours outside of the capital. Protesters had been marching peacefully, according to witnesses, when a group of pro-government thugs drove up on motorcycles and started to fire into the crowd. Genesis took a bullet to the head. Her friends took her to hospital by motorcycle, but that bullet was so firmly lodged in her brain that the following day she died, Anderson.
She is obviously just, you know, it is just one death. This conflict has been going on now for quite a while, but this photo, this image, what happened to her, you say has really had an effect on protesters.
It certainly has for several reasons. Young people really have been at the forefront of these two-week-old protests against the socialist government. They've been calling for an end to the crime wave, which has been sweeping the country. They've been calling for the government to get inflation under control, which has been raging at over 50%. And they've also been calling on the government to do something to stop some of sometimes chronic food shortages in the supermarkets and stores around the country. So very much Genesis Carmona's story, Genesis Carmona's reasons for protesting are the reasons for tens of thousands of other Venezuelans as well, Anderson.
And what is the latest tonight? I mean, I know police, National Guard troops, these private militias, thugs, as you said, have been swarming through the streets of the capital over the last few days.
They have. Now, what we also have to take into account, of course, is the government's point of view. President Nicolas Maduro firmly believes that it is the right-wing opposition who are starting this violence and seeking to bring the country to conflict. We do know that Venezuela, for the 16 years of its socialist experiment, has been a deeply divided country. For the president now calling the opposition members fascists, he's accusing the United States of meddling in this as well, and saying that some of the opposition leaders have actually received funding from the United States. Right now here in Caracas, things are calm. We've just come from a student protest. That was small and pretty peaceful. But after dark is sometimes when things kick off. Some of the opposition protesters will set fires up around their neighborhood, set trash on fire. And at that point, then you might have security forces moving in to clamp down on that. Or you might have these armed bands of thugs roving around trying to frighten protesters off, Anderson.
All right, Carl Pinhall, stay safe. Thank you, Carl.